S-curve phase one. Visionaries recognize a problem or opportunity and conceptualize a better way to do things. Phase two. Innovators move the concept from the laboratory models and sketches to working prototypes or pilots. Phase three. Early adopters form niche markets, connecting supply and demand. Performance increases and costs decline, but the innovation remains at a premium and not widely available. EVs are too expensive, they say. Phase four, the innovation reaches mass market. It disrupts and begins to destroy the competition. It outperforms incumbents in costs and performance. This is the steep part of the S-curve. Phase five, growth slows as disruption begins to take hold across an entire segment. Innovation reaches market saturation. The innovation may be transferred to new markets or serve as the basis for further innovations. That steep part of the S-curve, that's what we just hit. 102% growth. All right, I reported on the EV sales in Europe a few weeks ago, but those were preliminary sales numbers. We now have the official sales numbers from Europe for the month of August. And, well, they expose something very, very interesting. The media is telling you one story. The truth is something very different is actually happening. Hello, my friends. Welcome to the channel. Great to see you. Thank you for tuning in. I'm Sam Evans. Got to say a big welcome to all the new subscribers. It's great to have you. Now, I want to say thank you to, there's been a few people that have recently joined the Patreon group, the Electric Viking Patreon supporters. And I'm really, really thankful to you guys. Really grateful to you for supporting the channel. Even really small amounts really help us out. So thank you. And also our YouTube members. It's great to have you guys. We do post some videos in advance for YouTube members. I'm planning on having a series of Patreon videos. I've just got to get to it. There's always so much to do, but they'll come soon. New EV sales have increased 102% in Europe. 102%. So I reported on these incredible increases in EV sales in Germany, 170%, 160% the previous month before. People said, it's just Germany. I said, no, it's not just Germany. It's all of Europe. No. The news told me that no one's buying EVs. Volkswagen Group had to pause EV production because no one's buying their EVs. Well, yeah, maybe, but doesn't really make any difference to the fact here that the reality is that EV sales have grown 102% versus the same month last year. Now, if this happens again, that means we'll hit 42% EV market share next year. 42%. How long before we hit 100%? Yeah, you can imagine it won't be long, because now European automakers and European politicians, I would say even more so, are freaking out. They're freaking out because all of a sudden, Chinese EV sales have suddenly spiked. Now, Chinese EV sales have been doing nothing for the last 12 months. NIO's CEO is saying things that are truly bizarre. Now, if NIO's CEO, if he was called Elon Musk and he lived in America, he would get reamed by the media. The media would be constantly using him as a talking point, saying, this guy's crazy. And they'd be... But he's not, and for some reason he gets given a free pass. He said things like, the EV sales reported for our company are 3 times higher than what's been reported, and then he won't give an actual number on their sales. Truly bizarre comments. But anyway, NIO have increased their sales in Europe, which is good news. And they've been given a lifeline. NIO love spending money, and they've just been able to borrow about another $1 billion, basically from investors. So that's good news for them. But getting back to the story here, new car registrations in Europe increased by 20%. Mostly, well, not mostly, but entirely thanks to an increase in EV sales. Recent registration data from JATO coming from 28 European countries reveals that nearly 900,000 vehicles were registered in Europe in August. Of these, 200,000 were electric. So nearly 21%. That's a 102% increase versus the same month last year. Demand for EVs has jumped significantly at the same time that the Volkswagen Group says that their orders have dropped sharply. So who are the orders for? Well, we'll get to that in a minute. The countries where sales have really exploded include Belgium. We never talk about Belgium, but in Belgium, EV growth has increased by 224%. Greece, it increased 183%, Luxembourg 164%, Portugal 164%. If you make ICE vehicles, you've got to be getting a bit worried. Electric vehicles are particularly popular though in Germany. Registrations rose 171%. Germany accounts for 44% of all EV demand in Europe, and the reason being it's the biggest car market in Europe. Now, this doesn't include the United Kingdom, by the way. So what were the best selling electric cars in Europe? Here are the top 10 across 28 European countries. Tesla Model Y was in first place. Now, there's currently a link, if you Google my name and the channel, there's a link. One of the first things that comes up is the Electric Viking is a Tesla fanboy. So I probably shouldn't be reporting on this, because once I report this, people say I'm a fanboy if I tell you the statistics. Interesting. Anyway, Model Y sales, 21,550, increase of 208% versus last year. So a big jump in Model Y sales. Will we see Model Y sales grow as a result of the changes? If the changes that have just been made this week to the Chinese-made Model Y are made to the European model, we'll definitely see an increase in sales, because they've improved the interior, not massively, but enough to make people think that's a nice improvement. They've also given the car a probably 70 to 100 horsepower. We don't know the exact number, but it's around 70 to 100 horsepower more power, more range, about 2% more range. The long range version has around, I think, 4 to 5% more range. Some nice upgrades, no extra cost. The cost is exactly the same. This should help increase sales. So should the new version of the Tesla Model 3, which is now starting to be delivered in Europe. You can order those in pretty much every European country now. If you order the Tesla Model 3, you get the new version. Sales of the Model 3 grew 307%, 11,943 deliveries. In third place was the ID4, the Volkswagen ID4, with 9,135, an increase of 61%. Volkswagen ID3, 6,835 deliveries. In fourth place, a growth of 86%. Skoda Enyaq, 6,600, plus 45%. MG4, 6,302. Dacia Spring in seventh place, 5,800. Fiat 500, 5,735. And the BMW iX1, which is BMW's cheapest electric car, had 4,700 sales. That's a new model, so we don't know the increase versus last year. MG4, we don't know the increase versus last year. But if you look at this list, you can see there's quite a few Chinese cars here. Tesla Model 3 is made in China. Now, of course, the MG4 is made in China. The Dacia Spring is also made in China. So of the top seven best-selling electric cars in Europe, three of them are made in China. You're probably thinking to yourself as well, ID3, right? It's doing pretty well. I mean, it came fourth place, growth of 86%. Apparently, Volkswagen is saying the problem for their electric car sales is not necessarily their sales in August, but it's their future coming sales. They're saying that they had about a year. Volkswagen Group, I don't think this is true, but they tried to claim about 6 months ago that they had 1 year of pre-orders for all their electric car models, in particular the ID4 and the ID3. Very hard to believe that that was true, considering they're now shutting down production of the ID3 for, well, at one factory, I think permanently, at another one part-time, and then firing a number of staff there, saying, and they've publicly said their demand has gone down. But then we're seeing numbers like this. But what's most surprising for me with these numbers is the Model 3 sales. All of those Model 3s, those 11,943, were all the old version of the Model 3. All of them, every single one. So will we see a rise for Model 3 sales over the next few months? I think it's almost certain. I mean, how many videos are there saying, I mean, car wow, right? Millions of views. Tesla Model 3, best car ever. I'm not sure that's even true. I haven't driven it, but that's what they're saying. That's going to have to drive some sales to Europe for sure. Currently, what this means is the Tesla Model Y is the best-selling car, not EV, but just the best-selling car, period, across all of Europe. And so far this year, it's the best-selling car in the world. JATO Dynamics said this: it's likely the Model Y will be Europe's most popular passenger car by the end of the year. As a non-European model leading in Europe, this hasn't happened for decades, it will be a remarkable and historic moment. Now, for multiple reasons, never has an EV been the best-selling car in Europe. Never has a medium-sized crossover been the best-selling car in Europe. And never has an American car been the best-selling car in Europe, at least not for the last decade. So that's quite a few records there being broken by the Model Y. MG is also doing really well. It entered the top 20 brands in Europe in August, outselling Jeep, Mazda, Mini, and Suzuki. In fact, in regards to its EV sales, it registered more sales than Audi, Opel Vauxhall, Peugeot, Renault, and Skoda. And this is just the beginning for MG. I mean, they're going to just bombard the European car market. This is part of their strategy, part of their plan. And keep in mind, I mean, this is a company that's majority owned by the Chinese government. So you can see why the German politicians now are getting very concerned. Now, the thing worth considering, though, is that EV sales for other brands, other Chinese brands, are still very low, as in Chinese brands, not Tesla. Very low. Dacia, of course, made in China, but it's not a Chinese brand. MG accounted for 70% of all Chinese vehicles sold in Europe, totaling 200,000 sales. So MG is basically the only Chinese car brand that's really doing well in Europe. That will change. I think that will change. Right now, BYD, they're charging way too much for their EVs in Europe. If you don't agree with me, just look at the sales numbers. Basically, all of the Europeans are saying that's the case. So you can disagree with that on an emotional, personal level, but on a factual, logical level, it's simply a reality. BYD, will they reduce prices in order to get more sales? Almost certainly they will. Just a matter of time, in my opinion. At the overall car market in Europe, Volkswagen is leading. That's pretty much the norm. Volkswagen sold 99,300 vehicles in August, which was a 10% increase from August in the previous year, 2022. I've just given people these sales numbers. If you want to see them, they'll be on the channel now. There'll be a YouTube video showing record sales numbers of electric cars in China. They've now nearly hit 40% market share in the world's biggest car market. So we've got this happening in Europe, that happening in China. That's more than half the world's automotive sales in those two areas. EV adoption is just staggering, amazing. The media should be telling us that. They should be saying, hey guys, you know what? Yeah, global warming's terrible. We've had the hottest year on record, but hopefully this helps us head in the right direction. Let me know your thoughts in the comments, and thank you for watching.